What's going on, everyone? This is A-Wiz, formerly known as Achilles LBT, coming at you with a brand new video. And in today's video, my first video in quite a while, my first actual video in quite a while, we are going to be showcasing my newest obsession, if you will, Varian Wrynn. I just want to give a heads up, like, right away. Because Varian, I don't know if you guys, like, the ones that have been staying with the channel, that have been watching my videos, if you recall the Greymane era, basically, where, and I don't mean this is a good thing, I mean this where every single patch that would come out for a stretch, and it was the KT era before the Greymane era, every single patch that would come out, they would just nerf, like, just chip a little away at him, just chip away a little bit more, just keep reducing his effectiveness one patch at a time. Varian essentially is under the same exact treatment at the moment, only in the opposite way. Every single patch that comes along, they just add a small buff, a minor buff, that contributes a lot to the bigger picture with this hero. And the reason why I'm bringing this up, well, number one, it means he's at a fantastic spot. It's a good time to learn this hero if you haven't already learned him. It's a great time to pick this hero if you're not already picking him. But the reason I'm bringing this up is because not only are you going to be getting a Varian video today in regards to an experimental change to my build that was advised to me by one of my viewers on the stream, but that also means that next week I'll probably be doing another video on Varian when his latest patch goes live. And just to give an idea of what that new patch is on the next one, because again, it's just one, it's usually like one or two things that they just keep changing on him every single time they update the game. The new change that's coming next week, as of this recording, is that these three talents right here are going to be moved and swapped out for these three talents right here. So that means that you're going to start getting the banners at level 16, which is really not that big of a deal. But the huge buff to this scenario is that these three bad boys right here are going to be moved up ahead in the game. You're going to be getting these a lot earlier. And if you've never played Varian, honestly speaking, all three of these options are monstrous. These are juggernaut-like talents, in my personal opinion. Shattering Throw being my personal favorite. And I'm actually hoping that we get to showcase Shattering Throw in this video. And I also hope we get to showcase it in the next video. But getting to this video, the change that I'm making is right at level 1. And again, it was actually pitched to me by a viewer on the stream, and when he mentioned exactly the philosophy behind it, I actually thought it was brilliant. Now, me personally, I didn't have the balls to try this out directly in Hero League, because I feel like when you change up your build, to some degree, essentially, you're changing up your playstyle, and I didn't want to put my team potentially at a disadvantage simply because I changed my talent 1 to something new without knowing exactly what it's going to do. So this video you're going to be watching right here is going to be my first attempt at it. And again, just to kind of give you an idea of how much I've been playing Varian here lately, like I just like straight spammed him in Hero League to end my stream yesterday. And we finished off we had a 6-game winning streak going at this point, and we just kind of dropped the ball on that 7th one. But that's exactly why I didn't want to experiment. That's why I didn't want to change it up, because I didn't want to put my team at a risk by trying a new talent out at level 1. But again, we're here on this video right now, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing.
We will forge a great destiny.
All right, this is attempt number 2. Find ourselves on Braxis Holdout, and the friendly composition will be an Illidan, Azaria, Tassadar, Azul'jin, and myself as Varian. Excuse me for readjusting my headset. Going against the Stitches, Aurel, Chromie, Azul'jin, and an Asmodan. So, chicken is unhappy. The chicken is happy. Okay, guys. So, the usual talent I would pick at level 1 more often than not would be High King's Quest. But for the purpose of this video and the experimental build that I just got to try out for the first time to interesting results, would be Overpower. Now, the change that they made to Overpower the last time that they adjusted Varian was that if you successfully parry an auto attack while it's active, you not only refresh the cooldown of your heroic strike, but you also increase the damage of the following heroic strike by 25%. So basically, you get like a double strike. You get offense. You're rewarded offense. I cannot talk. For defense. Defense leads the way to offense. That's the idea. In a nutshell. So, the idea behind this build in specific is that we would use our taunt that would force a target to auto attack us and then parry it right away to queue up double damage. So essentially, whatever we taunt, we could essentially help delete. And again, I just tried it out in the game before this that I clearly lost because I'm not uploading it. Or it's not so much that we lost, but it was just not competitive at all. Seeing as the last game wasn't usable, I decided to play another one. I actually lost track of exactly what I was about to say, but I got some pretty interesting results out of this approach last game, and I want to see if I can get better results out of this and actually get a win. We'll see how it goes. You never know how these games are going to go until you're actually in them, so hopefully this one goes a bit better and we could actually make a thing out of this. At the very least, if you're seeing this game pop up on the channel, then you know it was somewhat acceptable to, like, to end up as an upload. Because I'm not going to, like, there's a lot of videos that I just kind of leave on the shelf just because they're not good enough. And it's like, you know, after a while you kind of lose the will to try and record a video, like whether it's because you're upset or you're actually drained from trying to explain things over and over again. It's just a number of things. You just see, like, the high volume of damage we're able to deal with our heroic strike. It's pretty insane. It's also worth noting that we have a double shield comp. So, keeping our guys alive should be a little bit easier than normal. I don't have stun just yet. But we are dealing significant damage to whoever we engage on. Hopefully that remains a thing. I am actually going to back off here a little bit because I'm taking quite a bit of damage right there. And again, the enemy team does have four, so that's something that we have to be mindful of. I'm going to move in on stitches. I'm going to parry. Oh. And we're going to go for Warbringer. So now we do have our stun in place. I'd very much like to help here. Zul'jin in the top really needs to, like, keep his eyes open on the objective here. Like, I shouldn't have been able to see that without actually clicking on his spot when he's actually up there. And by me pinging this right there, I just saved us a little bit of a problem because we were, like, very low health here. So it's not like we can continue to hold that down against the enemy team who wasn't low health. Just a little fun fact for anybody who, like, watches my videos and think that I'm not aware of things and because, you know, I don't do this. I don't, like, manually look every single place that I, like, want to, like, know what's going on. They do have a minimap, friends. The minimap is your friend. Is it as good as actually looking at stuff? No. Definitely not. But it still helps. We think the same way. Thankfully, I lucked out right there big time and I didn't get caught. Because it was looking like I was about to get caught. Illidan's trying his best right now. I am going to parry that. This is kind of hard. Like, I'm at a tough spot health-wise. Illidan is continuing to put pressure. Losing top as well. This is not good. So, as is the case with most varying games, these are going to be a little bit of a struggle until you hit the higher levels. We should try to put more pressure towards the bottom lane because they have the two highest health pools on their team stacked together in the top lane. So we should be trying to make a play out of the bottom instead, not the top. Do this. Ariel wisely used her whip. Time my parry. I caught in the Chromie trap. And they got a 100% Zerg. So yeah, getting videos this morning appears to be like the hardest thing in the world because like these games are not going very well. I understand that they're AM games and whatnot, but still. I'm going to move up here and help defend. I'm not sure what Zul'jin thinks he's going to accomplish right now going 1v3. Maybe he's just trying to pad his stats. I really wouldn't put it past, guys. I need a shield. Honestly, I have two shield givers right here, and like neither one, like until I bitched about it, were giving me a shield. We are gonna attack on Victory Rush just to at least give us a big heal every like. It's supposed to be every minute, The thing about this talent that I absolutely love, though, is that, like, you just saw right there, we went from very low health to full health in a matter of, like, seconds. Simply because we were standing in the middle of a lane, and every time a minion dies, you shave off 15 seconds off of the cooldown. So essentially, it makes Varian borderline impossible to kill so long as he's surrounded by minions. And again, the reason why I go for this talent over the second wind, honestly, second wind lost a lot of its value when heroic strike switched out to ability damage as far as like the healing being overpowered. So that's one thing. Two, second wind really gets the majority of its value from like attack speed. So like, unless you're going twin blades, you're not gonna have attack speed like in your arsenal at all. So it really doesn't make any sense to go for a heal like that isn't strong enough to keep you alive strike for strike if you don't have the auto attack speed to warrant it. Whereas the big heal that we just went for, you have no problem staying alive, especially if you're in the middle of a lane. It's just one auto attack that heals you for a bulk of health. So it's a good trade-off. You need to be wary of the Stitch's hook right there. Fairly obvious that he was going to do that. Zul'jin's in a tough spot. Oh, I gotta kind of peel for him a little bit. Not sure how that's gonna work out. Now, one thing I have noticed that I'm doing, like since switching up the level one talent, is that I'm moving forward a lot more. Whenever I parry, like I feel like obliged, if you will, or I'm not sure what the word I'm looking for is, but I feel like I need to move forward to kind of get the benefit of that level one choice. And that's something that I was never doing when I had the other talent that I was. When I was High King's Quest, I never moved forward like that just because I'm parrying. So again, that's something that comes with experience. I definitely think this talent is very good and it has a place with this build, especially when we hit 10. When we hit 10, you'll actually see the idea come to fruition. The idea being that you want to taunt a target, forcing them to auto-attack you so that you deal like a large lump sum of damage to one target by ulting them. And again, you'd be able to make that work like pretty often because the cooldown on taunt is really not that hardcore at all. There we go. Again, like I feel like I should be moving forward whenever I do that. Perhaps not the right call. You see, because we're in the lane right now, it's really, really hard for us to get killed. Taz Dingo was perfectly timed right there by Zul'jin. You see right there, the level 1 talent choice, we actually would have gotten a kill if he hadn't used that talent. We just bursted him down really fast right there. It's worth mentioning that was only my first death, and it was really a bad death because we shouldn't have been fighting at all, considering that they had 10 and we didn't. It's hard. Like, just to kind of get real with you guys for a second, it's hard to micromanage and pay attention to every little detail when you're trying to record a video, because that's something I would have never done if I wasn't like focused on trying to get a message out like while recording. I would have never engaged right there because I know better than to fight somebody when they have ults and we don't, regardless of the situation. And right there, I just made a fundamental mistake simply because I wasn't paying attention to like that like valuable information that is the XP bars. So now, speaking of XP bars, we finally have 10. So now we actually can afford to engage a little bit here. Illidan, he got 8. Rip. I'm assuming he has Metamorphosis. Yeah, he does. He still had full health right there because he was able to get away. It's just so hard, like, right now, honestly. But you see the damage we were able to deal on Zul'jin right there. Honestly, Zul'jin is less of a viable target for me to attack than Stitches is. Simply because he has Taz Dingo, so it's like, even if you burst him down, essentially, all he needs to do is just use his ult, and he's fine. And again, we made that mistake again. I know you're busy, but please prioritize handling the Zerg.
We are clear of the Zerg. Huh. Who designed this ramshackle facility? Oh, wait, I did.
It's a waste of time, unless like we can stun him out of it. But it's a waste of time if we put all of our efforts into Zul'jin while he has Taz Dingo. We're just putting all of our abilities on cooldown for a guy who doesn't die. And again, that's another mistake that I just made. Not so much it's like, oh, my teammates did this. No, I made the mistake too. So it is what it is. Oh, the slowing sands. So hard. I missed my taunt right there somehow. I don't even know how that happened. We're still down 3 levels. We really shouldn't be trying to fight right now, especially with a merc camp pushing top. But here we are. Throwing punches. Getting shoved all the way back to our base. The flip side to this is that the enemy team is so blood hungry right now that they're actually not camping, which is great. Now, I am going to do this. That'll queue up my damage. Of course, the Oreo whips me behind. Oh, we just lost our Taz Dingo. That Merc Wave is getting ever so close to our keep, so it means I can't actually help on this anymore.
Here we go again. The beacons are powering up.
To try and get back as much health as possible. Merc Camp, thankfully, is done. I don't know if Zul'jin has his ult off cooldown here. Four levels down. This is not looking like it's going to make it to the channel, guys. Honestly. I'm going to just keep this going just in case, like, we turn this around. But I'm not seeing it. This is just basically going the way that my last game went. Where we're not soaking lanes, we're taking stupid fights. We're getting caught over and over again. Nobody's working together. It's just, it's hard, man. It's hard. I know I brought it up before that I have times where I'm not uploading videos simply because I cannot get a game that's good enough to upload. And again, the minute I do that, the Oreo just whips me behind. Were it possible to get that kind of Oreo on my team? She's on point with her ults, too. Like, it's crazy how good this Oreo is playing. There we go. I did not have a shield on me there. I didn't see Tassadar shield anything right there. Like, he could have easily put, like, at least one shield on me, and I would have been okay. But, you know, apparently that's too much to ask for. I don't want to be negative in the chat at all, but like, it kind of hurts when you have two shield heroes that aren't shielding their allies. And I legitimately ran like across the map, like side by side essentially with my guys, and like low health the entire time, no shield put on me. I was like, what do you do? If you got a support hero that doesn't want to support, then you're kind of screwed. Back away. Illidan can take that down faster than I can. Here comes Stitches. Gonna taunt him. This time we did get that. Zarya ult might have actually did more damage than it did good. Got a situation going on down here. Illidan had to back away. I am taunting this Aswadan. Doesn't appear like it's going to matter, though, because the slowing sands are at the perfect spot for this team fight for them. They're just making all the right plays, and we're not. It's just one of those mornings. Yeah, this is looking like game. I'm going to go defend top. They're going to push core, which is what they should be doing. I mean, I can't actually defend by myself anyway. They're going to get the full Zerg push as well. Just really everything going right for the enemy team right now. We're not working together at all. It just hurts. They're attacking the core finally. slowly move down here. I'm not mounting up because I don't want to get there too soon.
Allied keep destroyed.
I'm not going to lie. These are the kind of games that actually, like, ruin my mood, because it seems like every game I'm playing against a squad that just fully appreciates and understands the importance of working together, and I'm on a squad where we don't understand that at all. Took out Oreo, big deal. They're chasing after Chromie. We're gonna lose the game here for sure. Well, this is nice. They're padding their stats for kills, basically. Zul'jin that died 10 times, an Illidan that died 7 times. Like, how well can you play when you have those kind of death counts?
MVP.
Jeez. I don't even know what to say. Like, I know I didn't play a good game at all, for sure. I didn't play a good game. The one death I had when we were down 3 levels was a terrible death. That's completely my fault. We were down 3 to 4 levels pretty much the entire game, it feels like, and we just kept fighting instead of soaking. Also bad calls, but, you know, evidently that's gonna happen, you know, because I guess it's just that time of the morning when, like, matchmaking is just not really that strong. Or the amount of players on the game are just really not that high. Or the fact that we have a PTR right now, maybe everybody's playing on the PTR instead of the actual client. Or the people that are playing on the actual client are playing Hero League. There's a number of reasons why that went so bad, but, you know, that one scenario where I died simply because I had 2 shield heroes that refused to put a shield on me that could have helped. Essentially, that buys me time for my big heal to kick in, and also for my damage to kick in through the taunt overpower setup. But again, you know, what are you going to do about it? Well, what can you do with that? I made several mistakes engaging on Zul'jin as well. The one guy that you literally cannot afford to engage on once he has Tazdingo, it makes no sense to engage on him whatsoever. You're just getting your team killed. We made that mistake as well. I'm almost tempted to, I don't know if this is going to end up on the channel, but I'm almost tempted to upload this just for the simple fact that, you know, I kind of want you guys to know that it's not always that I'm not trying to put videos on the channel or I'm getting lazy by uploading stream highlights. I go through my phases where I have games like, if you want to look at the difference, the sheer difference, it's crazy right now between Hero League, where I had this good little, I had negative momentum going for a little while. These are a lot of wins. Right here. I had a lot of, negative trend. That's what it was. We had a hardcore negative trend going, like, leading into these games. And then we started getting a positive trend that was slowly, like, amounting to, like, ranking up and whatnot. And more often than not, we're getting, well, right here we had another negative stretch as well. This is the other one I was thinking about. And then we followed that up with the big win streak that we had yesterday to kind of offset that in a big way. You see all the wins we have on Hero League. Now, if you go over to Quick Match, where I just play just to play, sometimes I just want to try things out, sometimes I'm just looking to have fun, the amount of losses we've been getting in Quick Match is staggering right now. Like, you're seeing some blue there, but you're seeing way more red. Like, my Quick Match quality has taken a severe, like, hit. I don't know what it is, but, like, it's insane how bad my Quick Matches have been. And you know what? I think I will upload this. It just won't have the title that I was aiming for. It won't have the goal that I was aiming for either. So, you know, it is what it is. I wanted to put something on the channel, a direct upload. I didn't want to put a stream highlight. And again, this is good to showcase that, you know, it's not that I'm getting lazy. It's not that I'm not trying to put in the work, and I'm not forgetting about you guys either. I do, like, I appreciate the fact that the channel has been getting subs despite the fact that I haven't been uploading as much. But I still think it's good to upload a video like this. And honestly, I don't really see other YouTubers doing stuff like this where they upload a bad game and kind of explain some of what's going on behind the scenes with that. And again, when I record, I'm not paying attention to every little, every single, like, minute detail the way I would if I was just sitting there playing quietly, or to some degree the way I do when I'm streaming. Because, like, if I'm streaming and I'm paying attention to the match, like, if I have nobody watching, I have full rein to just focus on what I'm doing, so obviously I'm gonna play better. Whereas in these videos, I'm focused a lot more on trying to showcase a specific aspect of whatever it is that I'm doing, and that focus goes a lot towards making sure that the dialogue is on point. I don't write anything that I say, I wing it. 100% of the videos you see for me uploading HOTS when I'm talking about things, that is literally me winging it. I do not write anything down. I simply know what I want the video to be about. I hit record and I just start talking, and that's basically how I do it. And I feel comfortable working like that, honestly, and it's not something that's bad. It's just sometimes my performance in particular is going to be lower than usual, because that does take up a lot of my focus, and I'm going to miss out on small details that I typically don't miss out on. So I think this is a good video for the simple fact that I can showcase something like that. And again, it's something that I don't see other people openly showcasing, or you know, admitting their flaws, if you will. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Like, I do apologize for the low match quality, my low level performance in this one. I don't think my game here should be a reflection of this talent choice. But again, another thing I did showcase here is why I didn't try this out in Hero League. Essentially, my personal flaw, this is what I'm sharing here. My personal flaw in my game with this exact talent is that if I use overpower at level 1 and I hit parry, instinctively I think that the right choice is to move forward to get the benefit of that the added damage. And that's not the way you should be playing this. You shouldn't be trying to force the issue. You should just let it kind of come to you. So while I think it's a good talent, and I think my friend, my viewer, might actually have the playstyle to make this work, because he told me that he tried it out and he dominated with it, I 100% believe that. It's personally, like, not without some hardcore work and redesigning my own game, reshaping my own game, it won't work for me the same exact way. But that's just me. This is why you pick heroes and you try out talents by yourself. You don't necessarily go 100% on what anybody says on YouTube, what anybody says on Twitch, what anybody says on a forum. If you know how to make something work, do that shit. Do not let anybody talk you out of it, because they are not you at the end of the day. They don't have the same exact mechanics as you. They don't see the game exactly the same way as you. If you know how to make something work, despite what anybody else thinks, use it, put it in play in games, shut people up, play your game, dominate. So, with that being said, I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to end this video. I've been ranting for a while. I guess I apologize for that. Like I said, I appreciate all the subs that we've been getting on the channel. With the in the midst of the inactivity, I'm going to try my best to record some more videos. I actually have the time now. So, I mean, I'm not going to let it cut into my streaming, because I'm really trying to make waves for myself, or, like, carve out a little spot for me on the scene as far as streaming. And I do mean a little spot. Me personally, I don't think my game quality is high enough for me to actually, like, be a big deal with the streaming thing. But it doesn't mean I wouldn't want to carve out a nice little home for me, like, amongst everybody else. So I'm not going to let, like, recording videos kind of interfere with, like, the time I have right now to stream. So there will be that. It will be linked in every single video. So there's also that. And hopefully we get a better run out of it then. And as always, I appreciate the support. This is AWiz, formerly known as Achilles LBT. And as always, that's Achilles with the Z. Remember it.